In this video, I'm going to be showing you a quick and easy way how you can include the links on your floor plans, sections, elevations, and so on. The idea is to have a symbol family that includes a link, and you can use this for brainstorming. So whenever you want to send over a project and then say, perhaps I want to use this type of railing and this type of glazing and this type of facade, and then you can include the links to the manufacturers. It's a really good way to include all of this data inside of your project. It's very interactive and easy to change. And I'm going to be showing you how to create this simple family from start to finish because it's quite simple. Let's go. Now, quickly before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. So as you can see here, we have our office building project. This is actually project 2 from our beginner to intermediate level course. So now let's get into it. And what we want to do here is we want to figure out a way that we can add more information to this model in form of a external link. So we want to add a link to some of the elements here. Now, in this case, what we're trying to do is we're trying to brainstorm still at this stage. So I don't want to say, okay, so for this wall, the final wall type is going to be this, and then include a link. I don't want that. I want to brainstorm so I can just add a link and say, perhaps we would use something like this. So that's why I want to avoid the option of selecting a wall and then going here into edit type and using this URL parameter here to add the link. This is a bit too permanent. Perhaps if we add a link here and then we decide to change something, the link might stay there, cause problems afterwards. So for the brainstorming stage, I want to kind of stay away from the actual kind of building information modeling part, and I just want to add a link as some sort of a tag, or in this case as a symbol. I just found that the symbol would work a lot better. So for that, let's use a symbol family. So here on the annotate tab, we have the symbol panel and the symbol tool. So to create a symbol family, we need to go here to the file menu, then go to new, go to family. And here I'm just going to open up the annotations folder, and let's go with just simple metric generic annotation. Of course, if you're using Imperial, feel free to use Imperial, and I'm just going to hit open. This is going to start a new family. Here we just have this note, which we can easily get rid of by hitting delete. And now we need to add some text. So for that, let's go to create. Then I'm going to go to text. TX is a shortcut, and then I can just simply click here in the center and let's type out URL, because this is going to be a link. So once we have that, I'm actually going to select the text and then just see, do we need to do some formatting? Yeah, let's just make it bold and italic and click on modify to finish that out. Now I can select this text and it's going to give me a little text box. And here I also like to set up the alignment to be center and center, both vertically and horizontally, just because if for whatever reason we change the text or the letter size, I want it to kind of go from the center out. Okay, so once we have that set up, the next step is going to be to edit the text family itself. So as you can see, it's black text. I would like to make it blue just to indicate that that we can click it and perhaps get the link or something like that. So I'm just going to select this and then go into edit type. And here for this 3mm text, let's duplicate this and let's just call it dash. Click OK and then change the color to, let's just use the standard blue. Click OK, apply, OK, and there we go. Now moving forward, let's give it a boundary as well. And for that, I'm just going to use simple lines and let's make a circle from the intersection here just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times, select the circle itself, and now if we want to make these lines blue, if I go here to subcategories, you can see we don't really have any blue lines here. We just have these two, and they don't work. So what we can do for that is go here to the Manage tab and find Object Styles, open that up, and here under Generic Annotation, let's add a new subcategory and let's call it Blue. Click OK, and then let's just change the line color to the same color blue. Hit Apply, OK, and now we can select these lines again for this line and then just make it, well, blue. Finally, to make it functional, we need to add a parameter, so let's go here to family types, open that up, and as you can see, we don't really have any parameters for this family. I'm just going to go to new parameter, and for the name, let's just call it URL. Then for the discipline, we can just stick with common, and for the data type, we can go with URL. And then we can group it under whatever we like. I'm just going to go with general. Also, I'm going to make this an instance parameter so we can have multiple ones with different URLs on the same view. Okay, so having done all of this, I can simply click OK, apply, OK, and now let's save the family and load it into our project. So for that, we just want to hit save. I can save it on my desktop. I've just named this my link symbol family. Save, and now let's load it into the project and close. So here inside of the project, what I can do is I can just come here off to the side like this, click to place, and then I can select this, go to add leader, and then I can simply place a leader just like this. So once we have added this leader, now we can add the URL. So for example, for this glass railing, let's say I have a company in mind. So what I can do is I can find that company online, copy the link, and then paste it here. So I'm just going to click here, Control V to paste this link. Apply, okay, and now when somebody clicks on this link, it's going to take them to the glass railing manufacturing website. And as I said, this is just kind of for the brainstorming stage where, yeah, perhaps we can use this. I have this in mind, something like this. Doesn't have to be exactly this. This is perfect for that situation. Also, this doesn't really look very good at the moment. So what I would do is I would add some sort of a leader head. So if I go into edit type, here we can see leader arrowhead. So I can just switch to something like, actually like the fill the dot. Yeah, looks really nice. Okay, so there we go. So we can just continue placing these along our model and then adding that URL here so somebody can easily click on that, see what the product in question is, and perhaps choose to implement that for this project or perhaps change that. I can see that and so on. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.